audience will cheer for me. Here will be different, but anyway, I will try to do my best.
All right, well, we'll leave it at that. So, Zamus, first tournament back.
Yes.
Made it already to the grand finals. Content, or you want the win?
I'm happy that I, first of all, qualified through the group stage, and I didn't expect to came so far to the final.
So now you're at the finals, you're playing somebody half the size of you. Is that going to help?
I don't think so.
Are you worried about him?
Yeah, of course. He's a good player, so we will see.
All right, then. Well, we'll leave it at that. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll let these two sit down. But when we come back, I'll be joining Joe at the commentary booth to bring you the grand finals. Please enjoy this great live match. It's going to be a best of five. It's going to be brilliant. Thank you. And it does look like we are going to have to go again live. And I don't think these guys are going to be too disappointed about restarting. I think Av3k had a small advantage and possibly could have capitalized on the first kill. But he definitely needs to make it happen again. So I guess Joe, we're back to the start. Are you ready?
Yay.
A bit of a warm-up commentary match there.
So, second match, although it's only the first one. Work that out if you can.
Okay, maybe you can.
There goes Av3k again.
Start.
The start. Yeah, it is the same start. And that will... see exactly how same it is in a second if
it's funny because Zamus
can get himself a rail.
Zamus is actually doing the same tactic. He's moved in after the mega to get the railgun. Currently with Zamus, gonna head towards that red armor. That's what he wants to pick up. If he doesn't challenge for it, he's gonna look to rail. Av3k a little wiser maybe to that movement, not being railed, so Zamus at a big disadvantage. There comes the first rail from Zamus, there comes the second, and that looks like a third, and there's a fourth, four in a row, and Av3k could probably take two more, because he picks up the Mega halfway through, but he won't take another one.
Brilliant.
And Zamus opens up the first frag.
He only missed one rail out of all of them, giving him an 83% accuracy, which
is absolutely crazy. I mean, Zamus playing on a Microsoft 3.0 SteelSeries mouse pad, very comfortable. He's got a low sensitivity with Mouse Excel, and he looks like he could be playing great here today.
Well, so far so good in this kind of restarted first map. And he is, of course, 1-0 up. There's still a lot of time here before this Mega and the Red are available to be picked up. And if you look at both of these players, fairly similar. So this next fight could be very, very interesting. Av3k missing the rail. Let's have a look at Zamus. They actually exchanged there. Zamus taking that low ground. Av3k will hit him back. And there's another couple of missed ones. And yes,
oh,
this is just back and forward with the rails. Av3k will hit the final one. And it will be enough to bring him back to a 1-1 scoreline. Looking to convert here as well. And he's got Zamus trapped there if he so wishes to. And he's definitely done a lot of damage. And probably Zamus won't be able to do much right now indeed.
Yeah, Av3k did a great job as well. Because even though he didn't get the kill, he's taken a lot of the health on the map and forces Zamus to pick up all the health available on the side of the red armor. So if Av3k to go to red armor, and now he could probably capitalize. He is going to want to push, and this is going to be troublesome for Zamus. Av3k is going to drop down, and that's a good play from Zamus not to want to commit to the end of that fight. Backing away will give him some more time, but honestly, Av3k, he's set up for the next frag. Zamus is going to have to defend very well to keep this 1-1.
Av3k certainly moving with a bit more pace here. He knows that if they were to meet, chances are he's coming out on top. Just watching out for the rail there. He saw Zamus switch over. He is going to have the free reign on this Mega, and this is a very, very clever idea from Av3k, but he needs to be careful that he's not caught out. He saw that he just saw the Mega was up, but decided to go over to the red instead, which again is still on his platform. Once he gets the kill here, then he'll charge straight over and make sure that he can get in on that red, and that's clever, clever play by Av3k.
Yeah, he's done great there, and already he's done a huge amount of damage with the LG. Nice! Oh my god! One stray grenade off the back, and then Zamus shot a nice one, actually forcing him into the first grenade. And that was a double, and we'll pick him up the frag. Now we've got Mega and Red Armor spawning at the same time. Zamus looks like he's going to pick up the Mega. That means Av3k will get the Red. One yellow armor to play for. Av3k will also pick this up. So he's currently at the vantage. The next power-up that's important will most likely be this Red, and Zamus is going to be in trouble. And Av3k gonna drop on him. Zamus probably not gonna escape. And Av3k will take the lead once again, 3-2, and he will wait out for the next red. And I think Zaymus is going to have a hard time defending this Mega, because Av3k has enough time to attack.
Yeah, of course, the last spawn, they were both together. This time, it's going to allow the split to give Av3k an advantage after collecting that red armor. It's up in just a couple of seconds here. Zaymus not keeping up on it just yet. Will do a bit of damage. There's a good rocket, and he will make the jump, but Av3k will LG him down just before he lands, and he's able to pick that Mega up. And that will be, again, well defended by Av3k. He knows that red's going to be up here in a second, and will get that rail onto Zaymus, who just crossed through the teleporter and has probably gone off towards that Mega room to try and get himself more yellow. But, well, there he is, come up the jump pad, and he's done good work here with those rockets. And Av3k will have to back away, but that rail, as he is backing away, will extend his lead to a three-pointer. It's 5-2.
Yeah, 5-2 the score. And so far, Av3k showing us that he is definitely ready for the finals despite having a rocky start. Zaymus steals away the Mega, but that's going to be nullified. Great railgun shot. Av3k down to only 6 points of AP. 50 will rectify the problem. There comes 100 to his name as well. Wow, Zaymus just comes flying in, and this is potentially going to be the kill. Av3k looking for a rail, but Zaymus picks it up. And I don't know if you can up your game sounds, Joe. I think some people were... considers the game sound to be lower, and maybe that's why the dead arm mic is slightly too loud, but we'll have to see. Anyway, following Zaymus, there comes the counter kill, and that's classic Av3k style. Will always go aggressive when he knows he can, and he knew that Zaymus was low. He's now got the majority of the power-ups, but didn't get the Mega, so these guys are going to be even. Big play for item is going to be the red, and Av3k taking so much damage. Zaymus knows he can capitalize, and Av3k also did a huge amount of damage, but Zaymus has come off better. He's got the 50. He can drop for the red, but he's actually going to pick up the health and let the red fall into the hands of Av3k, and that's an interesting play. I think he was not having time on red was a decision not to go there, but this could really hurt Zaymus.
Well, he's going to hope that he can get this cleanly, which he will do. And that now leaves Zaymus in a position where he can fight this next fight, but he's going to get hit with a rail, and his rocket, I think, did a little bit of damage as well there. As you can see, Av3k just waiting out on that spawn of the shotgun. Keeping the distance here is Zaymus, just holding that middle area. In comes Av3k from that teleporter, and will hit him with the rail. Zaymus in trouble again. Av3k going to go aggressive with the LG, and Zaymus not going to be helped too much by that 50. Again, Av3k's aggressive play, Jay, getting the better of Zaymus.
Yeah, but certainly this is Av3k's map to win. So far, Zaymus has really kind of held strong from railgun. But you're going to have to hit a lot of rails to knock Av3k off. Nice little bit of dodging, and the 50's not there yet. There comes another rail. He can actually follow up here, and he will escape. So a pretty good situation, considering it looked very bad and bleak to start with for Zaymus. But Av3k, up to that 200 armor.
Yeah, certainly looking very, very nice at the moment for Av3k. He's got that big stack. You look at Zaymus, who is just kind of struggling to pick up anything here. And again, he will land the rail. He's down to just 8 points of health. And Av3k will drop down after that rail connected. He knew he had that 50 to work with, but it wasn't going to be anything compared to what Av3k had built up in those last few minutes. And there's the red as well. So this 5-point lead, we've got 2 minutes and 44 remaining. Again, Av3k's going to chase down Zaymus, who will try to keep the distance and back off with the rail. Great shot by Av3k. And so Zaymus went for the cheeky shot. He knew that Mega was up, but wasn't able to land it. And Av3k again will get the better of him.
Yeah, and look where that railgun was dropped as well, just before the 50 that Zaymus was trying to pick up. And it was a good move from Av3k to go to the red armor, then the Mega, because Zaymus, when he walked into the Mega room, he was unsure if Av3k was going to be there. So by the time he figured out he wasn't, he was too slow to make it to the Mega. Av3k came through the teleporter and basically flushed him out of that room. So Av3k, having a good item run here. He's picking the right items, and it is catching off Zaymus at times. A lot of people would have gone for the Mega and waited, but this could be Zaymus doing some damage. But it is going to be Av3k that picks up the rocket kill, and a 12-3 scoreline with only 2 minutes to go. It is going to be the first map going to the young Polish superstar. But of course, this is the map that you would expect Av3k to win. Once we see some of the old school maps, which Zaymus has played since 1999 when released, then we're going to see maybe a different kind of Zaymus. But right now, Av3k taking advantage of the fact that he's good on the new.
Yeah, certainly. That's something that may just work into his advantage. You know, of course, we're playing best of five here in the final, not just best of three, so it can all be down to who wins maybe on these maps where they're, of course, the most even. And probably most people expecting this one to go to Av3k. Of course, it will be Zamus's pick next. And that's where he'll be looking to bounce back, because a 2-0 scoreline is going to be very hard for Zamus to come back from. It means he needs to win three in a row then, Jay.
Yeah, absolutely. To lose his map pick, that's going to be devastating. But Zamus already happy to be where he is. But let's see how this fight ends up. Zamus hits one railgun shot. Av3k will reply. And there comes a second. And finally, Zamus replies with two as well, and a great railgun duel, and actually Av3k almost went down, 14 points of HP, and he's going to be rewarded with Mega just now, and that's really going to affect Zamus's momentum. He's getting some nice shots though. He needs to take some confidence going into the second map. He took on with a jumping railgun there, decided not to go aggressive, and Av3k will claim that red armor once more. So into the last 20 seconds, a great game, but Zamus just not being able to kind of outthink Av3k on T7, probably most due to experience.
Yeah, certainly last few dying seconds here, and of course Av3k is going to go 1-0 in the lead. We'll be looking to extend that on the next one, which of course will be Zamus's match choice as Av3k kills himself at the end, but that will end it then. 14-2, Av3k will pick up the first map here. You look at the overall accuracies, and they're a little bit better for Zamus, but, you know, it of course is going to go to Av3k. So now it's Zamus to pick, and T9 is going to be the next choice. We're going to go back in. Let's have a round of applause for these guys. They've had a hard time here,
and they want to give you the best finals they can. But luck is against them, but certainly they're lucky to be a DreamHack. It's a great event to be at, and already Av3k once again claims the Mega and will get away barely with his life, and will pick up that 50, and that's going to put him in good stead for the next fight. These guys are pretty much even, and you can see that they, like, even Zamus is collecting every small health bubble he can to give him an advantage for the next fight. Av3k to defend the yellow.
Again, lots of spam involved in T9, and that's a problem for Zamus there. You just heard that click, and that would be him out of rockets. He's going to go out here with the LG by that mega area, and he is going to push Av3k away. So that's good work by Zamus. Now we're returning for more LG ammo as well as that yellow. And again, he will have that advantage, which of course Av3k had early on from picking up that mega, but Zamus rocketed it off him. And now Av3k has had to just build himself back up to 100 on the way out on more of these yellows, which Zamus is definitely collecting more right now, and certainly has the kind of edge if he wants to make a move in for this next kill. Or the first kill, as it is, actually.
Oh, Zamus got really out-LG'd at the start of that fight. He was lucky to do so much damage as he did. Now, Mega's going to be spawning. It looks like Zamus should be taking it, and Av3k is in a horrible position. Here comes potentially the first frag, and it will come in. And Av3k did a lot of damage with that plasma gun, and if Av3k picks up a clean yellow armor that will be spawning soon, they are once again even on the stack. Zamus is going to try and push him off the yellow before it spawns. Great play from Zamus. There's the yellow. He's also going to have the center yellow, and Zamus should be able to really run these three yellows and keep control over Av3k, and he's in a really good position to kind of extend his lead. Here comes the center yellow. Actually, Mega's going to be spawning same time. Av3k's going to steal it, but not before he takes a huge amount of damage, and looks like he actually rocket jumps out and is waiting for that top yellow.
Yeah, he certainly didn't, and that is of course going to be one less yellow for Zamus to work with now. And he has that 2-0 lead. We'll have to see for how long that lasts. Av3k playing it slow. They both go through the teleporter there, and well, Av3k did land a rocket, I think, onto Zamus. Let's have a look. Yeah, I'm looking at it. He did. And there will be another one around that center. Yellow is picked up by the Swede, and he will now make his way in for this Mega. He's got the disadvantage as far as height goes, but will pick up that Mega health, which of course gives him that extra 100. There's a yellow for him, did he want it as well? So Zamus again, keeping hold of that lead, and has the advantage as far as the health and armor goes.
Yeah, Av3k doing a pretty good job, catching some plasma gunshot, but Zamus claims another, and this is going to be bad for Av3k. He's cornered. Nice rocket, sending Zamus away, but still no armor to his name on that. A great rocket, and here comes another, and Av3k was all inside Zamus's head there. He knew exactly what he was going to do, and those two rockets were beautiful. There comes another kill, and that's going to bring it to a one-point game. Av3k claims Mega. A huge amount of damage. No way Zamus is going to get away from this, and we're all tied up 3 minutes into the match.
Yeah, I mean, what Zamus was doing there was really clever, but Av3k just knew it exactly. And, of course, if you're very clever, that's good. But if your opponent isn't already knowing what you're doing there, then it's, always going to be counted. That's how Av3k has got himself back to a tied game now at 3-3. 6 minutes 20 to go as he waits here for this next Mega Spawn. There is the middle yellow available for them. I'd say the lower yellow as it actually is. And there goes the Mega as well. So Zamus has forced himself back into this one now. And may well just challenge for this next kill. Av3k actually moving in from the central area there. That yellow is on its platform. Zamus will be out of rockets, but will be able to get in on that yellow as well. And Av3k not sure what he was aiming for there. Went over to the other side. They're going to meet head-on by that yellow. Well, it is going to be Av3k that picked it up, but it did take a bit of a dent to his health, especially. But there's a 50 to help out, and we're still tied up very evenly. Here comes a big battle around this mega area. He's going to spawn now in a second, and Zamus will survive with 20, looking for the conversion now. But Av3k has got an LG, too risky to move in head-to-head.
Yeah, it's crazy how badly Av3k got out LG'd in that last fight by Zamus. His LG was just off left right. It really didn't connect. And once again, Zamus really superior with this LG. He's got a 41%, Av3k killing a 32. And that's a big percent difference. And here comes Av3k with the trademark plasma gun. And there comes the kill that he needed. And a lot of power-ups spawning soon. He needs to get ready for Mega. I do think he knows the time. He's dodged the first rocket. He's done well. Zamus hits the air rocket, running out of ammo, but picks up the kill with the MG. 18 points of HP, and that was risky. There comes a 50 as well, and that's fantastic for Av3k, tying that one up. And he's got himself in a good position and pulled the same trick again. So trick me once, trick me twice. Let's see if he can do it another time, because Zamus has actually been abused, coming out of the teleporters, and it's actually helps Av3k a lot. So Zamus maybe should start thinking about taking other routes to get around the map and not just dart through the teleporters a few times. Mega going to Av3k. Zamus still has 100 armor to his name, so Av3k not a big, a huge advantage. If Zamus hits a clean rocket at the start of a fight, he will bring us to a very even game. But right now, Av3k has control. Well, I'll take that back, because Zamus just picked up another 50. Av3k also, so still in slight control. Mega spawning in 10. Big fight for item.
Nice little rocket there, actually, from Zamus. Came in, did a little bit of damage. Av3k hanging around that middle area. There comes Zamus once again, switching out to rocket, and that could cost him the fight here. But Av3k is going to run out of LG ammo, and then the favor swings back towards the Swede. He does get on that yellow, does Av3k, and he's again going to be cornered by that teleporter, but again will escape. And wherever he seems to be escaping to right now, things are spawning right in his path, and he's able to keep himself in on this battle. Now down to just 7. Let's watch Zamus here. We'll chase in, and finally we'll find Av3k, this time with a shotgun, and Zamus will take the lead here on T9.
Yeah, I think T9 probably reminds Zamus a little bit of, I think it was T2 on the voting, but it just, he's so powerful with the LG, he's really happy to take these constant LG fights, and they're working out for him a lot. He did just take a bad rocket, and he gave away Mega, so hasn't converted amazingly off the kill that he got. Av3k is actually 80 points in power-up advantage on the health. Zamus takes that 50, 100, 100, and one more 50, and he can start making something work. Nice rocket there. Looked like it was a pretty decent connect. He's trying to cover this yellow armor. If Av3k takes this, this is going to be very hard to push Zamus. It will be hard to push get rid of Av3k from this Mega, and Zamus is probably going to have to leave this fight. He leaves on 10 HP, and Av3k will claim that Mega. And once again, Av3k perfectly timing Zamus's route, and it's going to be another conversion, 7-6.
Yeah, Av3k doing well here to get himself in the head of Zamus, and of course get the kill afterwards. Well, now move into that lead. Could catch Zamus off here. There's the middle yellow for him as well. But again, Zamus is LG spot on for him. And that shotgun almost catching Av3k completely off. And and he's down to just 25 HP, and that 50 not available for Av3k right now, so he's got to just wait out and hope that there's some health going to come available. There is the 50. Feel a lot better about that, and that rocket was a strong one. Yep, this, again, losing out on his armor. Both players playing at quite a distance right now. They must utilize the machine gun as well as. But still, there's no real pushes coming in. They're exchanging kind of each other's armors here all the time.
It's only a two frag advantage for Av3k. 1 minute 30 to go. This mega, if Zaymus can take it, that's going to be his way back into the map. Zaymus needs to go aggressive. He knows it, and he takes a couple of bad rockets, and I'm not sure if he's going to get away as cleanly as he would like to, but he did take the mega, so he did the important job. He denied Av3k the mega, so now Av3k can't turtle. He can't just run away from Zaymus. Zaymus can force the next fight. That's what he's going to do. He's going to take the game to Av3k, and he won't back away. He needs to go aggressive, and potentially this could be it. Can he surprise Av3k?
Had to duck out of the way of that rocket then that was flying straight for him. Again, using those teleports. We've seen Zaymus do that before and being caught out by Av3k. We have 40 seconds to go. Here comes the mega. Av3k is going to collect it. Zaymus's rockets. That last one did hit, but I'm not sure how good it really was. And Av3k is, of course, going to try to hold on now for these last 30 seconds. Av3k running. Zaymus will try to chase. 25 seconds remaining, 2 points the difference, and when the first one comes in, the second one could follow very, very quickly here, straight off the spawn, but Zaymus has to catch Av3k out. Again, a good rocket will get in behind him. Av3k caught in the corner. He's managed to escape here, just 10 seconds remaining, and well, you can see the difference between health and armors, and it's pretty much even. Again, Av3k's going to run down towards that mega, will correct it, and that's going to win in the game here. Gets the kill in the end, and that will bring us to 2-0. To Av3k from Serious Gaming, and of course he wins 9-6 here on T9. Great game once again, Jay.
John, welcome to the cast.
Cool, how you guys doing?
Great to have you here, and we're going into the third matchup, but what's your take on the game so far, Av3k and Zaymus?
Well, you know, Av3k is an extremely aggressive player, you know, and it seems like it pays off on the long run. You know, at first I thought, you know, he's a little bit crazy how he plays aggressive. Cooler took advantage of him on one of the maps, but Av3k prevailed and beat Cooler in that matchup, so I see Av3k making a lot of aggressive moves, but they're very calculated moves too, and it works for him, you know.
Yeah, he's aggressive even when he dies on these aggressive attacks. Sometimes he comes straight back off the spawn,
I know, and
it just catches people off, and he just goes with any weapon, and it seems to work.
Yeah, and you know, that's kind of Cooler and Av3k both playing styles. They're super aggressive even after they die, and you could see in the DM6 match earlier when they were going head-to-head with each other, you could actually see them being very aggressive after dying, and that's very important because, you know, you only have so much time for the next armor and stuff to spawn, so it's important to be aggressive and get the guy low and, you know, keep the fight kind of even.
Alright then, so we are going to go into DM13, potentially last map here, match point for Av3k in this best of five, and we are live. Over you go. Yep, and it's both players actually getting that spawn towards the middle, and the machine guns here doing a lot of damage. I think Zaymus in particular there, yeah, he did look at how low Av3k actually went from that situation. But after all that, he's managed to get himself in, get the mega, get the red. Those bubbles will help him as well, and it will be advantage towards Av3k.
Yeah, the only weapon Av3k doesn't have is the lightning gun, so maybe he's going to try work his way around. You can see that Zaymus is trying to cut him off. Av3k going to be persistent, and Zaymus will give away this weapon. Now, Zaymus has got a job to keep Av3k trapped and trying to get that RA. He is a height advantage, does a decent amount of damage. Av3k nicely using that 25, and if he gets this mega, he can still probably claim the red. So he's done a great job. A little bit of damage. Nice rocket there from Zaymus, and he's used only position to take this small advantage, but he's done well.
And that was a great bit of work there from above from Zaymus. Let's switch over to him now and see how he's looking. Again, go in and collect that yellow. The other yellow around that middle area was picked up by Av3k, but not before he took a bit of damage. But here comes an aggressive Av3k again with the LG. Think he may have run out of ammo. He was down to just 9, so he wasn't far away anyway. And he had to back away. That Mega was spawning. He did pick it up. Zaymus got in on the red, but that third and that second rocket then from Zaymus just wasn't accurate enough. And Av3k will get the jump and also pick up the frag to go 1-0 up here. But again, if Zaymus goes aggressive, he could find himself getting a little lucky.
Yeah, Av3k's actually weak and he has no rocket ammo, so he's going to have to get claim some rocket ammo to take one of the fights, and he's actually given away red armor, so it's going to be a hard fight for Av3k. He has to use LG, he's going to try and escape, comes down, and that's an aggressive move, and almost pays off. Zaymus wants this Mega, 41 points of HP. He's going to fall on it. There's the pickup. Great job there from Zaymus.
Didn't take any damage there, right?
No, he didn't. And what do you make so far of this game, John? Both these guys playing a good DM13?
Oh, definitely. I mean, this game's this map's a classic. You know, we were playing this back in 2000 when the game first came out. So it's very exciting to see this, the new style with more yellow armor on the other side of the map with the LG. So game's a little bit different, but it's all about sneaking around corners and shooting precise rockets. And if you can get into the LG fight up here, I really like that.
And at the moment, Zaymus did do quite a bit of rocket damage to Av3k. He backs away, and oh, there's a horrible rocket, but he does flick Av3k, but Av3k lands one at the Zaymus's feet, and he claims the Mega. He was down to about, looked like 10 points of HP before he picked up that Mega, and Zaymus is probably going to be scratching his head over that one. He cannot believe he didn't get the flag, and he was expecting just to track the LG, but Av3k's rockets, absolutely amazing.
Oh, Zaymus is in trouble there as well, and that's two very, very accurate rockets from Av3k that will give him the 3-0 lead. Again, just rocket jumping up, taking that high ground, which of course can give him the advantage when Zaymus comes in for the next attack. And the yellows are just going all over the place to Av3k as well.
Yeah, that was a bit of a mistake from Zaymus there. He really could have dodged that rocket and decided he'd catch it. And not on the best of ideas, but he's done a great amount of damage with the plasma gun, but will crater. And we do see a minus one, so unless the gods of disconnecting bugs are going to intervene, Zaymus is going to have to fight back a lot harder now.
That's it, and Zaymus has just picked up that yellow. He's going to come in here with the LG, and it's brilliant from Zaymus, actually. Av3k really in trouble. That 50, of course, from the middle area should save him, and this Mega will be up here soon. Zaymus, of course, not going to go for that one. Doesn't feel strong enough to fight, and probably right being that as well.
Great rocket from Zaymus, though. He's done a pretty decent amount of damage to Av3k. Now, by holding Av3k in here, at least he knows he can probably claim two of the yellows, and that's what he's going to want to do. But he's looking for as much damage as possible. Both the yellows are up on his spawn point. Av3k sat pretty. Av3k could probably wait here long enough to claim a second red armor in a minute. That's going to be a little bit of a weird situation, because once he gets that red armor, he's going to be late towards the Mega. There comes the second red, but he did take a lot of damage, and he had it perfectly timed, and he's got to have escaped, and he's actually given Mega away. So I think really Zaymus came out on top of that one.
Well, that other yellow went to Av3k here, and Av3k's going to go for this fight, at least sticking around for a little while, and you can see that after everything is said and done, Zaymus still has that advantage.
Av3k played that brilliantly. Zaymus really didn't have an idea that maybe he could get in on that red and defend it, so by actually getting the Mega, he gave up two yellows and another red armor, so he's pretty much got nothing to work with in comparison to Av3k, so he's going to have to be on the defense, and there finally comes a Mega for Zaymus, but nice rocket there. We are past the halfway mark. Four frags the difference. Still very doable here, John.
Well, you know, basically Zaymus is going to have to find a chance to sneak up on him and get the first kill. You know, that's basically the only goal now, just to focus on getting one kill only, and then work from there. This map plays pretty slow, a lot of running and hiding and so forth, but, you know, you just have to find that opportunity and make the most of it.
Great play there from Zaymus, LG'ing Av3k off the red armor.
Yeah, I mean, a 4-point scoreline on the M13 can be enough, actually. And, you know, we saw in the early days, actually, the show match that we did with Av3k and Sturmy, and that was kind of proven there as well. And Av3k, I don't think he's kind of that player that will really adopt that style all that much, but
I mean, this map is mostly based around the, I think, you know, when it comes down to it, it comes down to who's controlling the, you know, the mega health. I think that was a huge factor on who would survive the fight by like 5 health. Was whoever was controlling the mega health usually won that fight.
Yeah, and mega will be spawning now, and it looks like Av3k is going to pick it up. Two yellow armors are available. Jamus currently claimed none. Av3k gets himself one red armor soon. And that's a big lead now as far as health and armor is concerned for Av3k. Jamus does hit one nice rocket. We've got about 15 seconds until the next power-up, so there's a lot of time for Av3k to actually capitalize on a kill, or maybe just play it safe and run the timer down, because at the moment, running the timer down for Av3k is probably a better game plan.
Yeah, I mean, right now, I would say this, you have to be finding your spots to get that attack in, because 3 minutes left in this match and being down by four frags, you gotta almost kind of give, like, 1 minute for each kill.
Well, he's got 3 minutes and he needs four.
I mean, that's the beauty of DM13. There are so many corners to set traps on that you just have to do that and hope that your opponent's going to run into you. You can see Av3k's position right now.
Yeah, I mean, like, the most important thing is when you're playing very defensive, you need to play in a position where you're playing 50-50. If he attacks from one way, you can escape the other. If he attacks from the other way, you can escape from the other. And also, you have to be able to use the sound in the game and really take advantage of knowing how to run away the best way possible.
Yeah, and also being able to kind of capitalize if someone pushes too aggressive. And actually, Zaymus does push Av3k down to 35 points of HP. He picks up a 25. Zaymus is down to 50 there as well. Very, very close fight. Zaymus picks up the red, and this could help him. He's got a small advantage, but he needs to find Av3k again, and he's only got 2 minutes to do this. Mega spawning in five.
And again, Zaymus will take that high ground, looking to see if Av3k is moving around the map, which right now, Av3k's content to just pick up whatever Zaymus is leaving free for him. Zaymus may push in aggressive, but again, Av3k will back away. Takes up 50 to give him an extra 5 points of health there. And again, this staircase is another one of those situations where you can really run rings around your opponent. Oh, what a rocket there from Zaymus, and decides not to actually jump up there for the finishing attack, but Av3k certainly having some health and armor chipped away again. Good defensive plasma from Av3k. Mega will be appearing in just a couple of seconds, but Av3k's not really interested in that. He will, again, like we said, just take up those leftovers and keep himself on the move.
I mean, Av3k's doing a great job of, like, basically showing the clock right here, and you know, obviously putting himself in position, like you said, you know, that great plasma gun, being able to shoot basically in a straight line, because your opponent, he sets up, he has to run in a straight line, sets up with you.
Yeah, and actually, Av3k just moved Zaymus closer to him. Here comes the fire, and finally Zaymus gets the kill. 4 points of HP to his name, and he's got to find three. Two power-ups are spawning now, so this is going to cost him 10 seconds. There comes Av3k, and actually he's probably going to have to chase. Av3k will just probably spam this out, and it does look like the Zaymus has probably got too big of a task. A smiley comes out from Av3k, and this could just be the game for him.
Yeah, there's Zaymus. Good rocket, actually, and he's going to fight over this 50. Ah, and he runs out of LG ammo just at exactly the wrong point in time. We'll get that kill. Two to go with 20 seconds. And Zaymus, if he's going to do this, has to get that next kill now, and then hopes to be lucky for the spawn.
If you actually check over to Av3k, you can see where he is. And he is very happy right now.
Yeah, that's the game.
There we have it then. That's going to be the game. 3-0 here at the grand finals. And Av3k takes all three of them. But Zaymus, you know, to take nothing away from him, he did absolutely amazingly to make it to the finals. John, any final comments?
Yeah, I mean, Zaymus played extremely well the whole tournament. I was very impressed about his T9 game. It seemed like that was definitely his map. The players he played, he destroyed. Obviously, Av3k was able to outbeat him on his map. And, you know, Av3k just played super aggressive, but it paid off in the long run. So sometimes it pays to be aggressive, and sometimes it pays to play defensive. But Av3k played super aggressive and made the right choices.
He did indeed. So we're going to go to a quick break. But when we come back, we're going to have the prize ceremony for these two guys. And then we'll be moving on to other such games. Joe?
Dude. I'm alive. Well, Jay, you with us?
I'm live. No, I'm not.
You can still be heard, though.
Really?
Yeah, so of course we've just seen the QuakeLive Grand Final taking place, and a thrilling three-mapper it was as well. And Jay, how did you enjoy QuakeLive today? Because I know you actually, from home yesterday, managed to catch some of the early stages as well.
Yeah, the QuakeLive was fantastic, just like my microphone right now. Pretty good games, but some people who casted it were great.
I'm going to use this microphone, and which I'm actually going to interview the player with. Yeah, some great QuakeLive, and actually it's been covered for the last 2 days. Some of the guys over at QuakeLive TV did it, and also Level Up, so props to those guys. Grease Scotsman, yep. DJ Wheat Slasher, and also Clamp OK was on there. But of course, at the prize ceremony, it's time to award those of excellence. And we've had like a lot of players here, some great players from all nations, and these are the top three, and it is Russia, Sweden, and then Poland. So let's go then first with third place from Russia, winning 10,000 sec. I just cut your prize money. It is, of course, going to be Kula. Please, ladies, a round of applause. Kula, third place, but you've trained a lot for this event. A few words, maybe. Are you disappointed, or just something to work on?
You know, I don't like single elimination because people don't have second chance. And today it was just first game of the day against Av3k, and I just played not so good. But I hope in future.
And what did you think about the finals? I heard you actually speak to Zamus over there with a few words of wisdom. You don't think he played his best game?
Yeah, I think so. I don't know why, but his last game against Termi, he was really, really nice. But on the stage, he played not good. I don't know, maybe he was scared, or maybe because of stage, because of the final. I don't know why.
All right, well, certainly a third place for you, but we'll see how you do next tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, Kula. So then, we go three and two, so let's go to two then. So in second place, from Sweden, he came out of retirement. He's done amazing to come through here in second. Please welcome, winning 15,000 Swedish krona, it is, of course, Zamus. With the pose. So then, Zamus, you dropped out of retirement. You know, you were gone in a sea of gaming elsewhere, and then you came back. And I told people why you came back. Can you tell us once again? I mean, why did you come back to Quake Live? Why did you come back to play?
Quake is a really nice game, first of all. And when I saw that all players had started to play again, I felt like maybe, why not? It's fun to compete and, yeah, meet people.
And how is this tournament for you? Obviously, second place is the people have to play with microphone volumes. Second place finish is still pretty good. Are you disappointed with your final performance? Do you think you should have done better for the Swedish crowd here playing on home turf?
27, I know I will lose. And T9, I would have win, and even 13, I think it should be a close game, but I lost all of them.
So maybe a little unlucky. So any last words to your Swedish fans, or any props?
I will keep go on with Quake, and yeah, we will see what happens in the future.
All right, then. So still in the game, ladies and gentlemen, Zamus. Second, third. And of course, one last man to award. He had a hard time here on stage setting up, and it almost looked like he wasn't going to get into the game, but finally he did. He is, of course, playing for Serious Gaming, sponsored by Razer. Please welcome, in first place, winning 25,000 Swedish krona, it's Av3k. So then, Av3k, how does it feel to hold the first place check, which is twice the size of you?
Yes, it's pretty nice. I like it very much.
Where would it go in your house? On your wall?
No. I don't know if I will take it because we don't have enough space in your car.
Oh. What? Just buy a jet.
Jet?
What? Like a plane.
Ah, plane. Maybe in future I will, but not now.
You win a few more tournaments. So you did just pick up the win versus Zamus. Did you expect to come here and win, considering you didn't play at Dubai?
No, but I really wanted to win, but I wasn't sure if I can do it. I was trying to prepare myself good and do my best games. So, yeah, I'm really happy that I won.
And any last words?
Thank you for the great tournament, for help to admins. And I wish you good luck. Thanks for to the Swedish audience. Thanks to my sponsors, and thanks to the players.
So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. A round of applause, not just for Av3k in first place, but our first, second, and third. And of course, they played a great tournament. And I don't know if you guys want to come together just for photos. Maybe you people would appreciate that. Some of the press, if maybe Av3k. You can stay on the side. You want to go center? I know you do. Go on. Go center, Av3k. So, yeah, that's cool. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. This has been the QuakeLive finals here at DreamHack Winter. Av3k is the champion. And when we come back later, we're going to be moving into more Quake with Quake World. So don't go anywhere. More Quake coming up next. And we'll also see some more games over the course of the days. We're here all Saturday and all tomorrow at the Dream Arena Extreme, powered by Telia.